Welcome to the University of Rochester's Pathology video series. This video will cover the normal histology of the urinary bladder. Access the NanoZoom digital pathology slides available through the U of R Histology folder. Locate slide UR-H120 to follow along as we discuss the microscopic anatomy of the urinary bladder. The innermost part of the urinary bladder is the mucosal layer, which is lined by a transitional epithelium, the urothelium, which is indicated by the arrow. When the bladder is relaxed, the epithelium layer appears to be made up of rounded to cuboidal cells. You may see special urothelial cells, known as umbrella cells, along the surface of the bladder epithelium, which have ample eosinophilic cytoplasm and often two nuclei. If you scroll down the same slide, you will see a cut of another section of the liver. Here you can see that in some places of the bladder, the transitional epithelium appears to be much thinner. If the bladder becomes distended, then the urothelium can be stretched out and end up consisting of stratified squamous cells. The basement layer, or membrane, is what separates the epithelium from the connective tissue that it lies on, called the lamina propria. The lamina propria and the urothelium both make up the mucosa. Underneath the mucosa is the muscularis, which consists of smooth muscle. The smooth muscle of the bladder is called the trusor muscle and consists of three layers: inner longitudinal, middle circular, and outer longitudinal. In most places, the smooth muscle runs irregularly except at the bladder trigone, making the three layers hard to discern. In summary, the urinary bladder is comprised of the mucosa and the muscularis. The mucosa is consisted of the urothelium and lamina propria, separated by the basement membrane. The muscularis is made up of smooth muscle. And lastly, the epithelium layer, also known as the transitional epithelium, can be either cuboidal or stratified squamous, depending on if the bladder is relaxed or distended.